Since the start of using paper currency, people have been trying to fake dollar bills around the world. Inside the US, the most commonly duplicated bill is the $20 bill, but outside, it's actually the $100 bill. However, despite their best efforts, out of the 759 billion US dollars in circulation, only $61 million are counterfeit, or less than 0.01%. At first glance, it seems not much harder than just printing anything else, but clearly it is. So why is counterfeiting money so hard? Well, first of all, if you try to photocopy money, which you shouldn't do, your printer simply would not print out the desired result. This is because of the Urian constellation, which is a set of numbers scattered across bills in a specific pattern that is recognized by photocopiers and nearly all photo editing software. And when they see this pattern, they won't let you either print the bill or edit it. So you're going to have to start off by hacking your photocopier or photo editing software to simply get a printable digital copy of a dollar bill. Even if you get a digital copy of the bill, you're still going to have a tough time printing because the paper itself is nearly impossible to replicate because it's not even paper. Paper is generally made out of wood pulp from various trees. Dollar bills, on the other hand, are actually made from cloth with a blend of 75% cotton and 25% linen. So criminals only have two possible options. They either have to steal the material or they have to make it themselves. Stealing the material is obviously very difficult. You basically have to rob the US Bureau of Engraving and Printing just to get the material. At that point, you might as well just steal the money itself. Now, making the material yourself isn't particularly hard and can be done. But the main limiter with this path is that it is very expensive, especially when done on a small scale. If you're just printing a couple thousand bucks, you would probably end up losing money due to your large investments into the material. Now, if you somehow get your hands on this material, your next challenge would be the color shifting ink. In the US dollar and most currencies around the world, color shifting ink is used. This ink looks different colors based on which angle you view the dollar bill from. The US dollar uses color shifting ink on the $10 and above on the bottom right corner of the bill. On top of this, on newer bills, you'll also find metallic ink being implemented. Metallic ink is what it sounds like. Once printed on a material, the metallic ink will shine like a metal object would. Clearly, these inks and printers are not cheap. The next hurdle is one of the best known anti-counterfeiting measures, as it is one of the most effective methods, which is the security thread. In US dollars, a small security thread is woven into the bill, which runs from the top to the bottom with the currency value printed on it. This thread can be seen by holding a dollar bill up to a light. Furthermore, depending on the currency value, the thread will glow in a different color when held under an ultraviolet light. Moving on, watermarks are also a very common anti-counterfeiting measure around the world. The watermark is simply a piece of ink that is visible from both sides of the material. For $10 through $100 bills, the watermark is the same as a person on the bill. On $5 bills, the watermark is the numeral 5, and for $1 and $2 bills, there is no watermark. Next up, we have microprinting. You know those solid lines that look like they're just part of the design on dollar bills? Well, actually, they're not lines. They're actual words printed in such a tiny font that it looks like lines. The only way to see the words is by using magnification. As you can see, there are a plethora of security measures taken to prevent the currency from being counterfeited. But in reality, it's not the security measures themselves that make counterfeiting impossible. It's actually the cost and expertise needed in recreating all of these security measures. First, you would need to spend hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions, to simply get the right machinery. Then, you not only have to source the expertise in quality checking your counterfeited bills, but also pay them a nice income to make it worth your time. And what about sourcing the materials? You would have to pay a lot of people, from the delivery man to the producer, to keep your entire operation undercover. Given the large number of people involved, it would not only take millions of dollars, but also an extreme risk, as anyone could crack, destroying your operation. And if you somehow get to the end and successfully counterfeit money, there's the issue of laundering that much money and actually making it usable, which is a whole nother ballgame. In the end, the whole counterfeiting process is a huge catch-22 situation. To be able to counterfeit money successfully and profitably, you need to have millions of dollars. But if you have millions of dollars, you aren't looking at counterfeiting given the risk. Simply put, there are so many other crimes that have a lower threshold of entry that are much easier to pull off and involve much less risk that counterfeiting money doesn't make sense. Given all of this, where did all the counterfeit money in circulation even come from? Well, virtually all the counterfeit money in circulation simply hasn't yet passed through a bank. No counterfeiters are getting the right materials and matching all the security measures in place. These bills have probably simply been injected at a local grocery store or gas station that didn't check the validity of the bill. Once these bills reach a bank, they will be deemed as counterfeit within a heartbeat. And that's the state of counterfeit money in circulation today and why it's so hard to successfully counterfeit money. If you guys would like to see more questions logically answered, then make sure to subscribe. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.